Lucio, so many people are asking us, how do you make the perfect tomato sauce for the perfect pizza?
And so it's no hard. If we follow a few steps, we're gonna get the right tomato sauce for the pizza.
For the pizza, yes. Come on guys, let's make it together. Welcome to
Vincenzo's plate.
Lucio's plate. Today Lucio is showing us how to make the tomato sauce for your pizza. It's easy, but it needs to be done right, eh Lucio?
Absolutely, there are a few steps to follow.
We want to learn, please master, show us how it's done.
Not a problem. One of the ingredients that we use for pizza is tomato sauce. What kind of tomato sauce? For Neapolitan style pizza, we will use Italian peeled tomato. It looks like a grape of tomato. San Marzano. San Marzano is a very sweet tomato sauce. It comes from Italy. There is a special land there that we grow all this beauty of the tomato. And all we do is we add salt, basil and olive oil in it. In relation to the ingredients, all we add is salt into the tomato. Quantity wise, we use 1 gram of salt for every 100 grams of tomato. So for this quantity, basically I got 2.5 kilos of tomato, so I'm using 25 grams of salt. Yeah. From my personal experience, things that we shouldn't do to the tomato sauce is using a blender. Yeah, we don't use a blender for the simple reason that once you blend all of these, basically you're blending all the seeds, you're blending the humidity, you're blending absolutely everything that contains in it, and all you get to the end is water tomato sauce. Yeah, it's a little bit watering at the end. So how should we treat the San Marzano tomato sauce? There are two ways that we treat it. One is basically crush by hands, the same way that I'm doing. If you don't want to do this step, another way you can use the vegetables mill. Yeah, so the vegetable mills will help also to blend everything, but just to let you know, it is very important that everything that you crush, you want to keep it there, it has to stay there, you know what I mean? It has to be coarse. We want all this flavor. Once you blend it, you will lose the flavor. You're going to end up with a lot of humidity, that this humidity, once it's cooked in electric oven, you will lose it. Another thing that I would like to add, do we need to cook the tomato sauce? No, because once you cook the tomato sauce, you will lose basically the beauty of the San Marzano sauce. It's sweet as it is, okay? So I do want to taste everything in it. And the best way to taste everything that is in it is to leave as it is, okay? Especially with electric oven, that the cooking time is a little bit longer than a wood fire oven, yeah? But I do want to make sure that my tomato ends up something like this, coarse, yeah? That's why we don't cook. And cooking the tomato, you're gonna get something that is flavor-wise is something completely different. Yeah, we want to make sure that we will taste everything in it. We will taste the seeds. We will taste whatever we have in the tomato. And basically, this is the consistency that we want to achieve. Yeah, that's why I want to suggest to use the blender, because you're not gonna get this sort of consistency. Basically, in this tomato, we have everything. We got the seeds, we got vitamins, we got the right consistency. You know, we wanna taste this on the pizza. And as I said before, all you can do, all we do is add the salt and basil. And if you wanna, guys, we can even add a little bit of olive oil. Before or after, for me doesn't matter, as long as we add the salt and the basil. And I tell you something even more. This step obviously is even better if you do a day before, because basil is the perfect marriage with tomato sauce, and basil will release a lot of flavor. This is it, guys. We just need to follow a couple of important steps. A simple recipe, adding a few simple ingredients. But the most important thing is we do need to use good quality Italian peel tomato, and you're gonna end up with a good result.
Lucio, thank you so much. Thank you. So everybody loves you on Vincenzo's plate. You're taking over, and see, simplicity is always the best. You're a professional pizza chef, and we can only learn from you how to make it. Mm. You're the master of Napolitan pizza, and you're also the master of tomato sauce for pizza. Thank you, Lucio. We're very lucky to have you here.
Pleasure, Enzo, anytime.
Thank you. So now it's time for you to make pizza. If you don't want to make pizza, you go and see Lucio at this restaurant. But it's pretty good. But I have to say, it's also nice to make pizza at home, Lucio.
Yes, absolutely.
So the next video, Lucio is going to show you how to make pizza at home in your normal oven.
Yes.
So stay tuned. E ora si mangia?
Grazie.
Vincenzo's plate, with Lucio's plate. Ciao, guys.
Ciao, grazie.